So our next subtitle is Lincoln's Reconstruction Plan. So this is now moving kind of out of the Civil War into more of the Reconstruction era, which unfortunately we ourselves are not going to get to cover this year. So the main problems facing Lincoln and the nation as a whole are how to rejoin the two halves of the nation and how they can integrate the ex-slaves and into society. Because remember that they've now suddenly kind of been cast out of their homes because they're no longer going to be on these plantations. They don't technically have jobs. They don't have houses. In some cases, families have been fragmented, and there's not a lot of education for them. And they find themselves, all 4 million of them, in a very hostile environment because the South does not like them and they're welcome nowhere. And they don't really even have the resources to care for themselves. So this is a pretty big problem still facing the nation, even though the war is over. So what is Lincoln's vision? He outlines this in the second inaugural address, as we talked about last time, and he tries to kind of make sense of the war. Neither side really wanted the war, but they both found themselves kind of driven towards it. And he says that the cause of the war was the peculiar and powerful institution of slavery. But now he emphasizes the need for reconciliation. And again, that important quote, malice towards none, and continued into charity for all. So he wants to bind up the nation's wounds and make a just and lasting peace. So significantly, Lincoln is not interested in punishing the South for the war. And we can see this in his plan, which again kind of follows the hard war and soft peace theme. So, he pardoned those who participated in the rebellion and restored their property rights, of course, except their slaves, on the condition that they swore an oath to the Constitution and to the government and all acts of the government relating to the freeing of the slaves. And there will be multiple of those, starting with the 13th Amendment, which officially frees the slaves. This pardon did not necessarily apply to high-ranking Confederate officers and former congressmen who supported the rebellion and technically broke their own oaths when they seceded from the Union. But, by and large, the states would be readmitted to the Union when more than 10% of the population swore that oath. And then he started encouraging the integration of the emancipated slaves and started planning for their education and their integration in the South. Although Lincoln kind of makes this sound nice and has this plan for kind of bringing the two halves together, many in the North really wanted to punish the South for this long war. And many in the South and in the North wanted to basically just ignore the freedmen and let them fend for themselves. So Lincoln not only had a task of bringing these sides together, but of confronting all of the people who were not interested in that. A lot of the North wanted to punish the South for all of the horrors they'd gone through in the last 4 years. So this is a monumental task now facing Lincoln in his second term. Unfortunately, as we're going to see, he will never get to accomplish it.